If you don't want to give your image a more contrasty look, so let's say you are more of a natural light shooter with a wide aperture, then you normally go through all the trouble that the image looks really soft, and to give it more contrast might be not in your best interest, but you might want to still give the image like a style. And for that, I recommend in some cases that it looks really, yeah, more romantic if you can give your image like this glamour glow look. And for that, you have different options. And first of all, I will bring all my layers back together into one image layer with Shift Alt Command E, as we did before. And first of all, let's go into the Nick collection. So over Filter, and then you go down, and here I have my Nick collection, and there are a few different ones. And the nice thing is that nowadays the Nick collection is for free. I had to still pay for it when it was made by Nick, but then Google took over and they offered it, yeah, for all photographers, that you can download this Nick collection now for free. The sad side is that they also just announced that they probably won't do any more upgrades of this Nick collection, which means if Photoshop brings out a new version in the future and yeah, these filters are not supported anymore, that would be really sad. But yeah, I really love using it, so I keep my fingers crossed that they will also, yeah, still do some kind of support in the future. So let's go in and go into the Color FX Pro 4 and see what we will do with that. So as you can see, you have these different effects up here, and they're already kind of, yeah, categorized into, yeah, I have my favorites. You see this, that I marked some of them with this yellow star. You can also create your own recipe, which I will show you in the next few lectures. And yeah, you can also go just through it and say some work maybe better with nature photography, and some of these presets might work better with portraiture. So this glamour glow you will find in portrait, and here you can see there are like all different effects that could also look interesting, like the soft focus, for example, that I quite like. Or you can use also like a high key or low key effect, but I want to show you for now the glamour glow. And if we click on it, then you see, okay, that's how the picture was before, and that's how it's with this new preset, and it's calculating the result. And you have a few options here where you could also say you want it a little stronger, or yeah, you can change the saturation, you can give it a different glow warmth if you want it more cooler or more like a sunny look. And for now, just to really show you the effect, I will go a little bit overboard and say, okay, it should be really warm. And then I will also add more glow, just so that you really see what this filter can do. And I think obviously if you go like 100%, that looks very tacky and cheesy, how you probably had these glamour images in the 80s. But yeah, you can obviously just change this here and give it a little bit more glow and a little bit more saturation, just so that you can really see the effect. And then because it will be its own layer in Photoshop, as usually with all the layers, you just go in and then you reduce the opacity. Or because this effect is obviously, yeah, it can be that it bleaches out certain parts of the image again, and then you can mask it out. So don't worry if you go here a little bit stronger just to see what this effect is really doing to your image, because later you can just easily mask those things out. So no worries. And then you can also play here with shadows and highlights if that affects your image. And they also give you this option where you could basically have control points where you can say, okay, it's this, I want more opacity, and here maybe less opacity. I never use these control points. I just go in and adjust this yeah, this effect over the whole image, so to speak. And then in Photoshop, if I want to mask anything out, then that's fairly easy. So for now, I will just go in here and say okay. Okay, and now when we go here on the eye to toggle it on and off, but we see the before and after. So that's the before and this is the after. So the image overall is a lot more like yeah, yellow, so it's kind of more sunny and it glows a little bit more. So it's up to you how much you want this effect on your image. And again, it always depends a little bit on, yeah, what is your image like? So I wouldn't put this on, yeah, if it's like an edgy image of, I don't know, somebody in a leather jacket and in front of a graffiti wall, then I think this probably looks a bit like kitschy, because then this glow wouldn't really make sense. But I think especially if you're shooting more in a high-key environment like what we have here, or if you shoot outside where it's kind of hazy, then I think this can give this image also this like a bit of a special look. And the other way how you can kind of receive a similar result, if you don't want to download the Nik collection, or if we are really unlucky in the future and they won't support it anymore, then you can also create, yeah, similar results in Photoshop, of course. So for now I just toggle this off. And let's concentrate on this layer here, where we created all these lower layers back onto one picture layer. And we just call this Glamour Glow. Okay, so we don't get confused. And now we have a few different ideas here how we can create the same results, but there are like a few different ways. So first of all, the whole idea of this glamour glow, as you can probably suggest yourself already, is that anything that's a glow is probably made by a blur and then with a blending mode. So for this one we just do the same thing. We go into our blur, into the Gaussian blur, and here you want to have a radius between, I don't know, like 60 to 100. So you want to go to a point where you still see the shape of your subject, but everything is pretty blurry. And then you go here and maybe like 70 or 80, something like that, and you just press OK. And if you now change your blend mode into soft light, then you get a similar result. If we just go, this was our Nik collection, and this is now our Glamour Glow. And as usually, I think this one was actually now on a lower opacity. Yeah, so we changed this. So if we go here 100% and now compare this with 100% and this, so you see it's pretty similar from the idea what this filter does in the Nik collection. So if we just toggle this off, and then here again you can play with your opacity. You can also mask any item out where you would think, no, maybe this kind of gotten bleached out. And if you are worried about that, that at any moment of time where you think you went a little overboard with brightening things of your image that might be in danger, that you are losing detail, then you can just bring this levels layer in. And this is just your control layer. You can delete this after you're doing basically your controlling. And if you're now just pressing on this key here again with the Alt button, the Alt key, and then you just see how many parts of your images are actually bleached out. And as we said, if they are only like spots, then this is fine. But if your image at any point gets like this, where you see only white or red information, then you have this risk that this will look not very nice when you print the image. So, but for now, it looks all good. So even if you wanted to have this effect on the 100% here, and you would like it, you're not running in danger that this is bleached out and therefore wouldn't look nice if you start to print this image. But I think the overall problem you have here is that whenever you apply any blur and then a blending mode, as we said before, it also can give you some kind of a color. So in some cases maybe this looks really good, because especially if you are shooting outside in the sunset and you want that everything is more saturated, then this might be awesome. Or if you think, yeah, actually I like the glow, but I don't want that the skin gets now overly yellowish, then you can also just go into your adjustments here again and click on Vibrance. And as we said, Vibrance is normally really nice for the skin tones. So you just activate this button here so that this only goes onto your Glamour Glow layer and doesn't affect all the other layers. And then you can just bring the vibrance down to a point where you're like, okay, I think this looks better. And this way you will have the glow on the skin. And if we just bring this into the group so that we can see how the whole effect is looking and we go on and off, then your skin tone is pretty much how it was before, not too yellow, not too orange, but yeah, overall you have now this glow on the skin. So this is one way of achieving this kind of more romantic glow. The other way is also quite nice, and for that we just bring in all these layers once more into an image layer with Shift, Alt, Command and E. And then we just do basically the same thing, only with one little adjustment. So for this one, we go in and say, okay, first of all, we want to convert this for a smart filter. And then it will just give me this message that we will enable now the smart filter. And we say, okay, you could also click don't show again, then this wouldn't come up because, yeah, we do want this. That's why we clicked on it, and therefore that's fine. And now you go into your filters again. And just go into the blur and the Gaussian blur, just like we did before. You can even keep the same radius if you were happy with that. And then you just go OK. And then we have a few different options here. So first of all, you can do as we did before, that we say, OK, the blending mode for this image should be soft light. And as usually, you can also experiment if it looks nice with overlay or any of these more extreme blending modes. But I think, whenever I play with blur, normally the soft light is pretty nice. And now you say, okay, now it looks exactly like it was before. So what's the difference? But this time you don't have to play around with your vibrance. This time you can play around with your Gaussian blur. Because the idea is in some way that you want to mix two different blending modes. You think, okay, I like that it's soft, but then I also would like maybe that it's not quite so much glow. And for that, you could now go into this little button here, or this slider area. And if you click on it, then it's quite interesting, because here you have now another mode where you can change the blending mode. And here you can go into screen, for example, and if you press OK, now you have a little bit more this natural looking skin color, but not so, it's kind of, maybe nearly like as if you go into the vibrance and you reduce the vibrance. So you're getting your skin color back. It's still obviously a little bit brighter than before, so you could still lower the opacity, or with the levels adjustment, you could just bring the color down. But overall, I think this is quite nice, because this way you have this glow and this stylized image. However, you don't have to bring in any adjustment for the skin color per se. And as usually, we can also try if this effect would look nicer if we just turn around any blending mode. So if we do it one more time and I delete this layer and bring in another layer, we can just do the same thing and maybe just switch the blending mode. So we can go in and say, okay, again, convert for smart object. This time I will say don't show again, because I want the smart object. So I press OK. And then we go in and say, okay, we want the blur again. And we just go okay. And then we say, maybe if we turn it around, we get a slightly different result. So we can say to the overall layer, we want this on screen. And then it would look like this, which could also be interesting for some images. If you then just go ahead and play with the opacity, you get this really hazy look, which might be also very interesting, especially if you have very, like a romantic wedding and it's all very hazy, then that's definitely worthwhile to just give it a shot and just to try it. And then you can go in here again, and then you can switch the blending mode in something else. But just make sure that you don't actually click on the Gaussian blur itself, because then it won't give you this option here. It just tells you how your blur was, and you could potentially change now the blur, but that's not what you want. So we just go okay. We want to press onto the slider here. So just a double click on this again, and you get your mode bar back here. And this time we say, okay, we have now the main layer on screen. So we want this Gaussian blur level on soft light, and say okay. And now we get a slightly different look than we had before. So before we had a lot more details, because the if we have this layer first in soft light and here in screen, then we just keep obviously a lot more of the contrast in the background. However, if we turn it around and say no to this overall layer, please be in screen, which makes the image brighter, then we get a different look. But this might be also very interesting, especially if we lower the opacity. Let's say we just want it maybe with, or maybe let's bring it up even. Let's say we want it maybe with 65 and we go before and after. Then you have this extreme stylized bright and golden look on her. And if you're worried that now obviously you're missing a lot of detail again in your background, then easily just with the mask up here and with B for brush, and then you just have your black foreground color. And then if you want it back with 100%, you can just bring this back into the image. So especially here where the screen mode will just bleach out all those details, now we can just bring this back. So that's definitely a nice way of giving your image also a very distinct style, but without that you're bringing in too much contrast.